The video is Le'ilu Nishmas, L'shmo Baruch Menchaim Tzvi Dov.
Anytime we have the opportunity to connect to the bracha of Oysa Maisa Bereshis, where you see the Yam, I always try to chap a rein. Why? Because it's an opportunity for all of us to remember the pasuk. The pasuk that says, Yikavu ha'mayim mitachas ha'oretz v'sereo yabasha. Hashem says, gather the water and the yabasha, the earth will be seen. Vayhichen, and it was. So this behind me is one of the greatest testimonies that there's a Boreh Olam, there's a creator, besides the beauty, the fact that this can't come from nothing, there's a designer. And it's something that's like, this is the way it was from the beginning of creation. No one was changed. Man did not have any input or change on the water behind me, the whole beautiful, magnificent picture behind me. So therefore, we always try to tap into that as much as we can. And we're going to continue now also with the fourth level of pleasure. We were discussing what the fourth level of pleasure means, which is love. Love between spouse, between a husband and wife, between a father and a child, between the mother and a child, between friends. What it means to have a real friendship. What it means to have real love. I was thinking about this a lot. What it really means to have a good friend. What does a real friend mean? And I want to also go back to the Rambam. We mentioned that there, when it comes to love, true love, is love that's based on the emotional pleasure you experience when you focus on someone's virtues, on something spiritual, on character traits, not on superficial, outside reasons. Now, how do we know that? So I mentioned that if you look in the Rambam and the Perash HaMishnah, it's Kedai to open up, it's Maseches Avos, in Pirkei Avos. It speaks about Ahava Tluya Badava and Ahava She'ena Tluya Badava. It speaks about the love of Amnon and Tamar, and it says that's love that's dependent on something, and therefore it wasn't lasting, as opposed to David and Yonasan, it was lasting. But wait a minute, so the Rambam says, but that's also Havayat Tlui Badavel. David loved Yonasan because he had the most amazing traits, or he was humble, or he was willing to let David HaMelech be the king without any jealousy. Why is that not considered Tlui Badavel? So the Rambam says, because anything spiritual is not considered Davar. It means it's something real, and that's the best relationship. When you love someone, and someone loves you because of who you are and the special traits that are in you, that's true love. That's real love. And the more we focus on that, the more real our friendship is. And I think it's so appropriate, since right now we're holding by Purim Katan and Purim and Shushan Purim Katan. What's the whole idea? So besides what we discussed, the interesting Chumrah, the idea of sending maybe Mishlach Manos, as my wife pointed out, the most basic concept of Mishlach Manos of Purim represents the idea of uniting together. How do we know that? Because it says that Haman said that our biggest fault was Yesh Doi Am Echad Mefuzo Mefoira. There's a nation that's scattered. When we're scattered, we're in trouble. How are we able to have the miracle of Purim? It's because we united. The more we focus on each other's traits, and everyone has an Akuda Toiva to be able to focus on. Sometimes it's hard to see, so you gotta peel those peels off and be able to see the beauty in each. Hatzlacha Rabbah.